Welcome to the Department of Mathematics of G.A. Momin Women's College. We are here with the next lecture of third year B.Sc. where we have seen the results of Maths Paper 3. These two results in the previous lecture, we have proved these two results. Arbitrary union of open sets is open in a metric space and finite intersection of open sets is open in X. But we had to yet prove, give an example to show that the arbitrary or infinite intersection of open sets need not be open. Although finite intersection of open sets is open, but the result which is for arbitrary union is not true for arbitrary intersection. So let us see the example to show that arbitrary intersection of open sets may not be open. If we consider R with usual distance, usual metric, and Gn as collection of open intervals, because open intervals are open sets in R with usual metric. So the open interval 0, 1 plus 1 upon n. So when we have G1, it will be 0, 1 plus 1 upon 1, means 0 to 2. Open interval, we can see the figure, open interval 0 to 2. Then G2 will be from 0 to 1 plus 1 upon 2, which will be 3 by 2. So it will be 0 to 3 by 2. This is G2, 0 to this. Then G3 will be open interval 0 to 1 plus 1 upon 3. So the intervals are decreasing in order. So G3 will be 0 to this. Suppose G4 from here to here and so on. So these are intervals which are in decreasing order. And when n tends to infinity, then it will be 0, 1 upon infinity is 0, so it will be 0 to 1, 0 to 1, but it will not be an open interval. Actually, that will be our claim here. What will be our claim? We'll see. This is G1, 0 to 2, G2, G3, like that. All Gn's are open in R because all of them are open intervals. Okay, but what happens? We will show that the infinite intersection of these open sets is not open in R. So what is that infinite intersection? Intersection of all these open sets. You see that this is first one, then this is second one, this is third one. So their intersection is this set. Okay, infinite intersection. So our claim will be that this intersection is open over here but closed at this end. That is our claim. So we will prove that this intersection of Gn's is open at 0 and closed at 1, this interval. So to prove this, we see that clearly for all n, 0 is strictly less than x, which is less than or equal to 1, and which is strictly less than 1 plus 1 upon n. If x is common in all of them, then x is in that, right? You see, when I say that x is an element here, means 0 is strictly less than x and x is strictly less than 1 plus 1 upon n. So we have this. Now this shows what? That when I take an element x here in this interval, then x will be what? X will be greater than 0 but less than equal to 1 because of this as a closed interval. But this 1 is strictly less than 1 plus 1 upon n. It means whenever I take an element x here, it is definitely, this element is definitely here between 0 and 1 plus 1 upon n for all n. Okay, it means when I take, you can see the from figure also, when I take an element x here, it is definitely in 0 to 2 also, 0 to this also, 0 to this. This element is in all G1, G2, G3, in all of them. So this closed interval 0, 1 is subset of the open interval 0 to 1 plus 1 upon n for all n. So it is subset of all of them. It means it is subset of intersection of Gn's. Because it is in all of them, it is common. So it is in intersection of Gn, n belonging to natural numbers, set of natural numbers means n is from 1, 2, 3 up to infinity. So 0, 1 is contained in this. Now we have to prove that intersection of this is contained in 0, 1, then equality will hold. Okay, in order to show that this is equal to this, for two sets we have to show that this set is subset of this and this set is subset of this. We have shown here that this set is subset of this. Now we need to show that this is subset of this. So we will take an element here, take an element here, show that it is here. That will prove that this intersection is subset of this. For that, let us take an element to prove this. Take an element here. We have to prove that it is here. We will prove this by contradiction. If we suppose that there is an element which is here but not here. So x, there exists some x which is common here, which is in this intersection, but x is not here. When x is not here, then x will be definitely strictly, because see, x is everywhere here, x is here, so x is greater than 0, because x is here means 0 is strictly less than x, which is strictly less than this. Right, when x is in all of them, 0 is strictly less than this, and this is strictly less than 1 plus 1 upon n. So x is greater than 0, but at the same time we have assumed that 0 is not in close interval, in interval this. It means this should be beyond this. It is not in this interval, means x should be greater than 1. Okay, but when x is greater than 1, then x minus 1 is strictly greater than 0. Okay, this minus 1 is strictly greater. So x minus 1 is a positive real number. So by Archimedean property tells us what? That for any x positive, there is a natural number n naught such that 1 upon n naught is less than that number x. So this is that positive real number. Okay, there exists some n naught natural number such that 1 upon n naught is strictly less than this number. But then when I add this number, this one over here, I am getting 1 plus 1 upon n naught is strictly less than this x. Okay, so x is strictly greater than this number. It means x is not in the interval 0 to 1 plus 1 upon n naught, because when x is in this interval then x should be strictly less than this number. When x is greater than this number, it means x is not in this interval. But this type of interval is gn naught. Okay, because what was our choice? Gn is 0, 1 plus 1 upon n. So gn naught is 0 to 1 plus 1 upon n naught. So x is not in gn naught, which contradicts what? This, that x belongs to the open interval of kind 0 to 1 plus 1 upon n for all n. Okay, for every n, x belongs to in that interval. But we have come to a contradiction that there is some interval 0 to 1 plus 1 upon n naught where this x is not belonging. This contradiction is because of our wrong assumption that there is some x which is here but it is not here. So this is not possible. It means whenever we have an element x here, it must be here. So this is subset of this. So from 1 and 2, this intersection of Gn is equal to this interval, which is not an open interval because it is closed at this end. It is closed at the right end 1. So the intersection, arbitrary intersection or infinite intersection of Gn's may not be open set. Although all Gn's are open, but the infinite intersection of them is not a closed set. This shows the example that arbitrary intersection of open sets may not be open. Now we come to one more next proposition, important proposition. If XD is a metric space, and we have to show that subset G of X is open if and only if it is a union of open balls contained in it. So one more criteria, that G is open if and only if it is union of open balls, all the open balls are contained in it. Proof: let XD be metric space and G be any open set. This is if and only if we have to prove both the things. So suppose G is open in X If G is empty, then definitely it is open set, and if this is empty, then it is empty union of open balls. There is nothing to prove. But when X is not empty set, then there must be some element, at least one element. Suppose there is some X which is an element of G and G is an open set. So by definition of open set that says what? For every element of open set, there is some open ball centered at that element with some radius r, such that this open ball is completely contained in G. It is a proper subset of G. So if this is true for every element of this, for every element of G, if this is true, then all such open balls will be contained in G. So union of all such open balls when X is a member of G will be completely contained in G, because by definition of open set, this is true for every member, every X of G, that there is some, at least one open ball which is centered at that, which is completely contained in G. So for every member X of G, this is true. So all such open balls will be contained in that, so their union will be contained in G. This is one thing. Now we have to prove that G is contained in such union, then equality will hold. So let us see this thing, that for every x belonging to G, singleton set X is definitely contained in BXR, because this is an open ball whose center is X. So definitely center is in this open ball. So this singleton set X is here for every element of G. So union of arbitrary or any such union of these singleton sets, taking union here, okay, taking union of all such X over what elements of G. So this union of singletons will be contained in union of open balls, right? But union of the elements of G, union of singleton X is such that X is a member of G, will be actually what? Union of all the elements of G. Union of all the elements of G is G itself. So the set G is contained in this union. So from 1 and 2, in 1 we have proved that this union of open balls is contained in G, and in 2 we have shown that G is contained in such union of open balls. Therefore equality holds. Therefore G is union of open balls which are all contained in G. The converse. Conversely, if we have to show that if 3 is true, it means if G is union of open balls which are all contained in G, then G is open. So suppose that open ball, you see, we know that open balls are open sets, and arbitrary union of open sets is open. Therefore, when we have supposed that G is union of all these open balls are open sets, and this is an arbitrary union of open sets, it must be open by the result that arbitrary union of open sets is open. Therefore, G is open. So the converse was quite easier than the first part. Okay, thank you.